Hello friends, in our YouTube channel, we are going to start a new playlist related to General Organic Chemistry, that is GOC. Sometimes we are calling also as Basics of Organic Chemistry. So if you have the strong base of organic chemistry, then and then you can be master of that and you can go ahead with this subject. So today we are going to start this subject with basics, very basics, right? So, first, we are going to learn the definition of the organic chemistry. So, suppose someone asks you a question, define organic chemistry in any interview or anywhere, so you should answer that, right? So, definition of organic chemistry can be understood as the branch of chemistry. Organic chemistry is a branch of chemistry which deals with the compounds of carbon, which deals with the compounds of carbon. But other than, but it compounds of carbon other than simple salts such as carbonates, oxides, and carbides, etc., is known as organic chemistry. As you know, carbonate possess carbon. Oxide like carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, etc. also possess carbon. Carbides also possess carbon. But even though they are not included in the definition of organic chemistry, so compounds of carbon with covalent bond to the other element like hydrogen, nitrogen, sulfur, etc. Right? So the compounds of carbon which deals with the covalent bond with mostly carbon, hydrogen and other heteroatoms are included in the definition of organic chemistry. Now if we want to learn the organic chemistry, first we should understand about why carbon is making organic chemistry and other compounds are not making such type of chemistry. As we seen in the definition, only carbon have a large number of compounds, which other compounds don't possess this much compounds in their chemistry, right? So the only carbon is making a large chemistry, right? So what is the reason behind that? The only reason behind that, the answer should be due to the powerful catenation power than other elements. The carbon is capable to get connected with more and more number of carbon, right? So carbon has a tendency to attach with more and more number of carbon, and this is catenation, right? So carbon has powerful catenation power. That's why it creates organic chemistry. Now a question may arise, the simple understanding is not enough to get idea about the catenation. But the definition of catenation should be what? Definition of the catenation should be what, right? So actual definition of catenation can be given as self-linking of atoms of an element to form chains and rings is known as catenation. Generalized meaning is the tendency to join more elements of same type is known as catenation. Actual definition is self-linking of the atom of an element to form chains and rings, that is called catenation, right? The common example of catenations or element that exhibits catenations are carbon, silicon, germanium, etc. Other elements are also there. In some competitive exams or some exams like NEET, JEE, GPSC, GSAT, a question may arise to you in your question paper, that is the catenation property order. So which is the correct order for catenation? So you can see the carbon has more and more powerful. The carbon has more and more powerful tendency to attach with more and more number of carbon. So it has highest tendency to make catenation. Carbon has highest tendency to get catenation. The second one should be silicon. The third one should be germanium. Fourth one should be tin. And fifth one should be lead. So these elements are showing catenation in decreasing order. So you can see highest is carbon, then silicon, germanium, tin and lead. So these are the examples where you can see the order, priority order or catenation property order of these elements. This may ask in some exams also, right? The next, we are worried about the valency of carbon. In some vivas, somewhere examiners are asking, what is the valency of carbon? So normally we are answering 4. Right? And it is the correct answer. But why the valency of carbon is 4? Or same question can be asked in another form also. Why carbon is tetravalent? So we should think about the answer, and answer should be what? First, we have to see about the atomic number of the carbon, and the atomic number of carbon is 6. And it must possess 6 electrons in their orbitals, right? So, if you see the ground state electronic configuration, it must possess total 6 electrons. So, if we draw the pigeon box diagram for the carbon's electron 1s orbital. 1s orbital possess 2 electrons in its orbital. And if we are going to see the next, 2s also possess 2 electrons. 2s also possess 2 electrons. And 2p possess 2. So if you calculate, the total number of electrons will be 6. Right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So if you see, in the ground state, there are 2 unpaired electrons present in its outermost orbital. Right? And now we should think, when carbon is going to react with some other elements and going to form some compound, it must enter into the excited state. So what will be the configuration of electron when it enters into the excited state? The simple answer, 1s possess 2 electron as above. 1s possess 2 electron as above. Right? But if you see the electron, 2 electron present in the 2s, one will jump to the 2p orbital, which is empty. So what should be the actual configuration of in the excited state? It is 2s1 and 2p3. So if you see the outermost orbital electronic configuration of carbon, it will be 2s1 and 2p3. So the excited state electronic configuration of carbon is like that, right? And now we are moving to the next slide, that is excited state configuration of the carbon. If you see, there are 4 number of unpaired electrons present in this excited state configuration. So carbon can easily gain, 1 electron over here, 1 electron over here, 1 electron over here, and 1 more electron over here. So it have 4 vacancy to get electron, and that is the key reason why carbon is tetravalent, why carbon is having valency 4. So this is all about the valency of carbon. In the next video, we are going to learn about the fissions of bond. how the bonds are going to be break, and we will learn details about that, the types of fission and everything. And by this way, we are concluding in this video, and we will meet in the next video. Thank you for listening me patiently. Meet you in the next.